Hello, men. Hope you're all well. It's a beast here. I just want to share a bit of my testimony and just encourage you in your own walk with Christ and your journey. For myself, you know, I got saved at the age of 16, and it was probably the perfect time for me because I was on a different path, and that path was going to lead me to distraction. You know, I was pretty aggressive as a youngster, actually a bit of a bully. Used to give my parents a hard time, and they used to worry about who I was or who I was going to become one day. So they never thought that I would turn the leaf, but thankfully God came and literally changed my life around. And, you know, when I got saved, that's when everything just started happening for me. You know, my rugby took off, and my academics also took off. You know, I became the perfect student from being a troublesome youngster. You know, my parents couldn't understand what had happened. My mom did know that, you know, I'd made that commitment, but my dad, you know, wasn't so sure what was happening. You know, and then from that very moment, you know, I never looked back. And even when I came over to South Africa, you know, the young 18-year-old trying to pursue a career in rugby, I was on fire for Christ. And I literally made a commitment right at the beginning of that journey in South Africa that, you know, God, if I make it, if I become a shark, if I become a pro athlete, I'm gonna honor you, you know, and I'm gonna use my platform to give you praise, and I'm gonna try and, you know, go out there and make disciples out of men for your kingdom. So that was literally the commitment I made to Christ, and it was a big one. And, you know, at the time I came here as an unknown. I was from Zimbabwe, this young kid called Beast. And a lot of guys underestimated me. You know, coaches, players, they kind of thought to themselves, you know, this, who is he? What is he going to do? What does he have to offer? So for me, I was on a do or die mission. You know, I knew that for me coming here was opportunity of a lifetime, so there was no going back for me. You know, I had to make it work. I had to make it a success. Otherwise, I was literally gonna die if that didn't happen. So I gave everything, you know, 110% in my work. You know, I used to go and do crazy stuff, gym on our days off. You know, go and and run on a Sunday and just completely like became obsessed, you know, with wanting to make it. And at the very center of all of that hunger, that dedication, you know, was my love for Christ. And I knew that, you know, with him at the very center of my journey, you know, this mission was gonna become a success. So I just literally, you know, walked with him from the very beginning, and things just started happening for me. And I played for the Sharks Juniors and made a huge impression. And after a year, pretty much the whole of KZN knew about this beast. And everybody got pretty excited. There was a lot of hype, you know, it's very overwhelming. And the following year, I got approached by the Sharks head coach at the time was Dick Muir, and he came and he said, you know, he wants me to be part of the, you know, the senior squad. He sees me as a future Shark, and he wants to offer me a long-term contract. And for me, that was a massive victory. You know, I remember just being on cloud 12 somewhere up there, just couldn't believe this was happening. You know, for a youngster that came here with nothing and literally a backpack and my boots and a few pairs of clothes and just a dream. And now I'd gotten my first contract, and it was amazing. I remember just thanking God and actually getting very emotional. And it was just, you know, it was just the start of an exciting chapter in my career. So obviously I got to don on the jersey, the Sharks jersey. And, you know, to this day, I've played over 150, you know, Super Rugby caps. I'm the most capped Sharks player of all time, you know. And it's happened like this, and all because of God's goodness. And I can tell you, you know, over the years, there were a lot of challenges. And, you know, one that comes to mind is my heart palpitations. That started in 2010, which was quite a big one, a big scare for me and my family. I literally went to training the one day, and then had a cup of coffee, and next thing I just felt my heart racing out of my chest, but I wasn't doing any exercises. I was sitting down, chatting with the with my teammates, then I just remember like getting the panic attack, actually thinking out to myself, what is going on? And went to go see the doc, and the doc said, you know what, you've got a heart murmur, so this heart murmur needs to be sorted out. So I ended up having to stop playing for a little while, but through all of that, I knew that, you know, God had a plan. You know, people started writing stories in the media saying, hey, beast, your career is done. You know, as soon as they hear heart and, you know, heart problems, and then, yeah, the whole world goes berserk. So there was a lot of talk, a lot of, you know, write-ups, but I just blocked all that stuff out, the negativity out, and like, what does God say about me? You know, and he says that, and I was healed through the blood of Jesus Christ. So I knew like, you know what, that's all I'm leaning upon. I don't need nobody else to come in and try and change my mindset, because I know what God is saying about me. And my family, thank God for my family. You know, they were around me. My wife was around me. And, you know, they always encouraged me. And then through all of that, I had to go for a procedure in Cape Town. I went and I did it actually twice. And it was 2010, 2011. And then after 2011, the symptoms totally went away. Never had any issues with my heart. No palpitations. I could run even faster than I could before. You know, there were a lot of people saying, I'm probably not going to be able to carry on for as long in my career. And there was a whole lot of all these things that were being said. And I just, you know, said, you know what, God is going to show you that he's not done yet. And then, you know, my career is going to take off, and I'm going to reach greater heights. So, you know, I just kept it that, and was persistent, and never looked back. And, you know, God has just taken me from, you know, from one level to the other, you know, from milestone to milestone, playing 100 caps for the Springboks, you know, playing 150 Super Rugby caps for the Sharks. All those amazing, you know, achievements, you know, that people said I could never attain, I could never get to because of my heart. But, you know, God showed that, you know, what, he's got the final say. And I trusted him to have the final say. And, so that is probably the biggest game changer in my life. You know, that moment when I made that decision to trust him, you know, through the challenges, through the, you know, all this big scares, you know, when I really just blocked out all the negativity and I listened to what his word said. That is, yeah, my game changer. And I just want to encourage you and all the men at Men of Valor, at Rhema this weekend, to really go after God and go after your dreams as well. And, you know, just keep on putting him first. And you will see just doors open in your life. And you will be the one sharing a testimony to so many men out there. And just really changing their lives. God bless.